Let me say this. You know, I get, especially now, you know, I'll go around and to places and I'll get a lot of praise about what's going on in the county. And I love the word renaissance. But as Jim said, it wasn't that long ago. It feels like a long time ago. I know I had hair and it wasn't as gray. And I was slimmer. But it wasn't that long ago where, you know, when I inherited the office, everybody was like, oh, my God, poor guy. I mean, why did he waste 8 years of your life trying to get that? But one of the first conversations I had was to the Senate president. And he said, I said, well, you know, I'm going to need help. He said, don't worry, I got you. We're going to make it happen. And what he meant by that was, we know that we're going to have challenges. But I believe in this county, and I believe that this county can do better. And if you bring the issues before us and you bring the problems to me and I can help you, I'm going to move heaven and earth to do that. If I didn't believe him when we brought down the first controversial bill we had, which was ethics reform, people don't talk a lot about that now. But the first bill we asked the General Assembly to take on was to say, you know what? We need to self-govern. We need to regulate ourselves. We don't need anybody stepping in. We know there are some things we need to change. There were a lot of folks back here in the county who didn't want that to happen. We thought it was a bad move. But the President of the Senate stood by me, and we pushed it through. And what has that done? That had meant for the business community who had some doubts as to whether you could get a fair shake in Prince George's County, that we weren't going to take it anymore, that you were going to be able to get a fair deal right here, because we were going to govern ourselves. But if it hadn't been for the Senate president on our side, we wouldn't have gotten it through. And the other stuff wouldn't have come along. We wouldn't have been able to get the EDI money through if it had not been for that first step. Because we could put money on the table. But if you think that you can't get a fair deal here, you're not going to come. But the thing that really let me know, two things that let me know that the Senate president cares deeply about this county, and I really couldn't stand here today if it had not been for his leadership. And I don't want anybody to think that I have the power to do all the things that have happened. The first was MGM. Now, I have been on the record as somebody who does not gamble, but when I saw the project down at National Harbor and the opportunity to bring jobs, entertainment, more than just slot machines and table to Prince George's County, with no chance at all, I said, this is an opportunity for us to actually do economic development. I went to the Senate president and I said, you know what, we need this done for Prince George's County. He said, we're going to make it happen. Now, I had a little bit of a hard time with some of my friends down there. And there were moments during that whole debate, whether you're for it or against it, during that whole debate, where it looked like we were sunk. And in fact, you know, the Senate president introduced one of the staff members that here, and that's Bradley Fromm, who I put on that project. And he was just looking like he is now, just kind of in the back. He's like, we're going to lose this one. We're going to lose it bad. I said, well, but the Senate president said we got a shot. He's like, I don't know, boss. At the end of the day, because of his work, because of his faith in this county, we were able to pull that project off. So what does that mean for us in Prince George's County? That means we have the potential to have two of the biggest projects going on in Prince George's County. An almost $1 billion entertainment at MGM down in National Harbor, and an almost $2 billion if we get the FBI going on at the same time here. Education reform. I looked at our education system and I said, we need to change it. In fact, you know, somebody said this the other day. They said, well, who puts in a bill 30 days before the session ends? Me. Why? Because I have a friend. I went to a meeting. I think he really did think I was crazy, did. I think he wanted to lose my number. But in 30 days, we passed a bill that radically changed education in Prince George's County. Radically changed it. We were able to get a superintendent that grew up here, educated here, was one of the finalists, one of four in the nation for superintendent of the year nationwide, was superintendent of the year in Maryland, all because we changed the governance structure of our education system so that we could attract teachers and retain them. I couldn't do that from Upper Marlboro. I could only do that if I had a friend, if this county had a friend, that believed in the future of this county and was deeply rooted in it, and that's our Senate President. Can we give him a round of applause?
Been here, folks.
Now you know why we love him. I do want to introduce, before I'm going to be very, very brief at this, I do want to introduce you, Mike. I'm done. I didn't.
Okay,
I'm not going to yell at you anymore. I still need you. Please run. I do want to introduce you, part of our team here that's made it proud. We have Aubrey Thacker, our acting DCAO for Economic Development Infrastructure. We can give him a round of applause. David Iannucci from our Economic Development. Everyone knows David Iannucci, doing a great job. Bradley Fromm in the back. And Jenny Nevins from County Stat. Jenny's looking like, why the heck did you just out me? Because you know what happens, and you know, you look at all this stuff that's going on, and you look at where we've come in the county, and it is a renaissance that's going on. I think people are believing that. But a lot of that work were done by young people working really hard and long hours to make it happen. One of the things that Jenny has held several positions with this administration, which I'm sure she didn't think she would do, you know, coming out of Yale undergrad, she'd be working in some fancy place. She didn't know she'd be working for the Baker administration, you know, in the bowels of government. But one of the things that we asked her to do was to help us with County Stat. And what County Stat does is look at the government as a whole and figure out how we can function better, how we can move it faster. That means a lot of work dealing with a lot of senior people in government and offering changes to people who worked in government for 30 years who don't think they need change. But that's what she's been working on, and she's done a fantastic job. And if you can help me, give her a round of applause for a great job. So now that I've used up all my time, I want to talk about this right here, quality of life index. I want to thank the Business Roundtable for doing this. This is exactly what we need. You have always been there when we've asked you to take on issues. But this is a great, great piece of work. You know why? The reason is I can say how great Prince George's County is. I can tell you that the quality of life is changing. And nobody would believe that, because what else am I going to say? In an election year, what am I going to say? Everything is bad? But when the business community, when an organization that has the cachet to look at it and to give an opinion that everyone knows is unbiased, it's the truth, that helps us. It helps us when there are good things about what we're doing in the county, and it helps us when there are things that we need, the challenges that we need to improve. So when we go to an agency in Prince George's County and say, listen, there's a reason why we change, we changed to DPI. We had all of our permitting, inspection, enforcement in one agency, housed in one location, so that we can try and get permits through faster, so businesses will know there's some surety. There's a reason. It's a good thing. There's a reason why we do the crime briefings, you know, used to be once a week, but every month, and bringing all the crime agencies in with others so that we can look at how we improve those numbers in Prince George's County. It's a reason why we do our signature program, our Transforming Neighborhoods Initiative, where we look at those challenging areas in Prince George's County and try and turn them around. But when, you know, the Business Roundtable does this and the media looks at it and says, okay, here's somebody giving the truth to Prince George's County, it helps us. It helps us. And so I want to thank you for always being here. I've said this before. I know he gets tired of me saying it, but it's the truth. I was smart enough to know, I'm not the brightest person in the room, but I was smart enough to know what I don't know. And that is, I don't know everything about the business community, and I don't know everything about government. So what I need are people who are willing to give of their time and talent, not to me, but to this county, and to help me. Jim, you know, a lot of people don't know this, but once a month we sit down and we run through a list of things and issues, and I shoot trial balloons, and sometimes he'll say, I don't know about that, Mr. Baker. But what it has enabled me to do is to have an unbiased opinion, somebody that I know won't run out and say, you know what, that guy just came with the craziest idea. It's a good thing I talked him out of it. But that helps. Not me. It helps this county. And so I want to thank the Business Roundtable for this index, and I want to thank Jim for his leadership. We can give him a round of applause. I will end with this. One of the challenging areas in the report is about education. We're going to do some radical improvements in our education system. I said this to Dr. Maxwell at a forum we had, and I didn't tell him I was going to say it beforehand because I wanted to put him on the spot. Because as I remind him, and as people remind me, we're both on the spot. Education is no longer in Sasser Building. Education is no longer in the Sasser Building. You're all here responsible for education. You know why? Anybody know why? Because before we put the bill in Annapolis, we came to the business community, we came to the round table and said, are you happy the way things are moving in our education system? People said no. Do we need change? We said yes. In order to get that change, we all have to buy in. So you're part of the change that's coming. It's right here in the business roundtable and in your individual businesses. If we don't progress, it is your fault. If we don't progress in education, it is the council's fault. Councilwoman Tolles? Yes. If we don't progress in education, it's the president's fault. But most of all, if we don't progress in education, it is my fault. It is the way it should be. The county executive is the leader of this county. There is no more important issue that faces the county than education. And what I said to Dr. Maxwell is we will, before the end of this next term, we will move up three or four places in this state on whatever measurement they do in testing. Because I know when I say, well, there's a test and we're ranked at the bottom, and somebody says to me, well, if you do a different test, we'll do that. Whatever the test is, whatever the measurement, whatever you judge other people by, this county will move up. Because if we do that, along with the other things we're doing, reducing crime, improving our economic development, we do that. We move up three spots, I guarantee you, you will see the likes of this county that has never been seen before. And we're going to do it because there's no other place in the state of Maryland that has the resources, the location, the talent, the people than Prince George's County. So I say it in front of you, and I say it in front of him, and I say it in front of cameras, we will move. Now, you may not like me at the end of it. You may be asking me to move on, which is fine because my wife and I are going to still live here in this county. And we're still going to want our property values to be up. And in order for that to happen, we still want your businesses to prosper. In order for that to happen, Dr. Dukes knows this better than anybody else, we have to have a first-rate K through 20 education system in this county, and we'll have it. That I guarantee you. Thank you.